capital city of the once very influential European country of Austria. Vienna is famous mostly for its links to classical music of the 18th century, and is known as the City of Music. Around the centre, you'll find plenty of grand and opulent music halls and theatres. However, if there's one thing that's missing compared to other European cities, it's a variety of history. Despite being a settlement since ancient Celtic times, sadly there's not much history that passes any more than a couple hundred years left to see. But I'm always up for the challenge of hunting out the best things to see, so here are my top picks from Vienna. An influential city in the heart of Central Europe, Vienna has had a varied history, being the seat of power for the mighty European powers such as the Habsburg dynasty and the Holy Roman Empire. It also marks the furthest place Ottoman forces managed to invade Europe in the 16th and 17th centuries, famously being repelled in the Siege of Vienna in 1683. Losing most of its historical buildings due to the modernization over the centuries and World War II, the most famous of the old buildings in Vienna is the Stephansdom Cathedral. So let's start with this. Located right in the heart of Vienna, this colossal cathedral was originally begun in 1137 to replace earlier places of worship that were deemed no longer suitable in size for the city's population. Added to over the centuries until finally completed in 1578, the cathedral is instantly recognisable for its steeply slanted tiled roof and the 136 metre high south tower. The cathedral incorporates both the Romanesque and Gothic architectural styles, the tower itself being a particularly impressive example of medieval design. Entrance to the cathedral is free, however you'll need to pay extra if you would like to ascend to see the views from the north or south towers. Usually I would do this, but you can see from this video what sort of weather I was getting on the days when I was here. Inside, the cathedral is splendidly decorated just like you would expect from a grand medieval cathedral. It did seem like there were suspiciously thin pillars holding up the roof. Speaking of the roof, this is not the original medieval construction, but was rebuilt after World War II as a fire destroyed this. Keep an eye out for all the intricate carved details that can be found around the pillars and the walls of the cathedral. Jumping ahead 600 years from the initial construction of the Stephansdom Cathedral is another religious building in Vienna, though this one is of an entirely different design. A landmark in its own right, it is constructed in the Baroque style, but incorporated some unusual architectural elements. The main entrance is styled like an ancient Greek temple, whilst two large columns flank either side of this, looking highly irregular for a Catholic place of worship. Being a Catholic church, the insides of the building are ornately decorated just as you would expect to see, and the oblong-shaped dome is graced with a magnificent mural reminiscent of the Sistine Chapel. Catholics certainly don't mess around when it comes to decorating their churches. The good thing about the Karlschurch for a visitor is that it is not just the ground level that can be visited. You also have access to an upper balcony. And that's not all, the roof is accessible too. Built in 1737, this church is instantly recognizable from others in Vienna, as it has two columns built into the side of it. And these are inspired by the Trajan's Column in Rome. I would say that there would be a stunning view out across the city from up here. Well, the weather saw to it that that didn't happen. The last place in this video is a museum located towards the south of the city. However, the building complex itself is pretty impressive. Constructed in the mid-19th century, the Vienna Arsenal was an imposing military barracks ordered by Kaiser Franz Joseph I. The buildings are attractions in themselves, inspired by the arsenal buildings of medieval Venice, and judging by this old photograph, have always commanded a military presence. Occupying one of the buildings of this massive 19th century complex is the Military History Museum of Vienna, and it is the oldest purpose-built history museum in the world. Outside are two aircraft of the Austrian Air Force, one being a Saab J-29 Tunnan and the other being a Saab J-35 Draken. Austria was one of a handful of nations that made use of some Swedish-designed aircraft during the Cold War period, so these were nice to see. Whilst brick-built buildings don't usually have much of an appeal for me, the interior of the main hall is quite something, with very decorative chambers and a lavish grand staircase. As a military history museum dedicated to the involvements of the Austrian army, the museum holds exhibits about major conflicts the country's forces have taken part in, from the wars against the Ottomans and the Thirty Years' War, to the campaigns fought during the Seven Years' War and the Napoleonic Wars, to displays of World War I, in which Austria fought a fierce war against neighbouring Italy. It's in this hall that another aircraft is found on display. Outside there are a few old tanks on show, however if you want to see more of these, a separate building a few minutes walk away is a treasure trove of military armour. The Panzer Hall is a fantastic display of main battle tanks, armoured personnel carriers, self-propelled assault guns and specialist vehicles. Top picks for me from here were some Soviet-era main battle tanks, and the museum's collection of World War II German armour in the form of the Sturmgeschütz III, Hanomag Half-Track, and Jagdpanzer 38 Hetzer. This attraction probably has one of the strangest opening hour policies of any attraction I think I've ever been to before, being that it only opens on the first Sunday of the month. Good luck catching the opening times for this one then, but if you happen to be in the right place at the right time and have a love of tanks, this museum will definitely impress. I did find Vienna a bit underwhelming, as it did not seem nearly as picturesque as Budapest, another famous city on the Danube, or other European capital cities. That said, it might have just been because it rained a lot and the sun was virtually absent entirely during my stay. The only way of getting some decent photos and videos was by going out at night. These landmarks are pretty impressive to see, plus there are other places that I didn't get around to in Vienna that would also be well worth a visit.
If you have enjoyed this video on the places to see within Vienna, why not leave a like and follow my channel for more, and I'll bring you many more places from Austria, as well as many other historical places from the rest of the world. However, until next time, see you around.